You the one who's trying to keep your business low key, huh?
So one thing you can't do at Alphaly is have a sick workout with this music playing in the background. Apparently we're doing this because there's a client in here that doesn't like quote unquote rap music. So I'm gonna have to endure this, but I have my AirPods in. Only thing that sucks about my AirPods is that they're not loud enough to cancel out the trash just playing in the background. Starting off this workout with incline dumbbell press. Gonna be doing anywhere from 110 to 120 pounds for 8 to 10 reps, 4 sets. I've already warmed up, about to hop into my first working set and get this shit pumping. Let's get it.
Yeah.
All right, so workout was swell here with the girlfriend, and we're in the apartment. So not the apartment, the townhome. I gotta get used to saying townhome. But the last time I was here, it looked like a complete mess. Everything was just all over the place, and they've definitely made a huge amount of progress. So we move in about 6 days. Today's the 22nd. I guess I can kind of give you all a little walkthrough of everything now that it's like a lot more, I guess, completed. This is the kitchen area. Last time you guys saw it, there was stuff everywhere. And now like the floors are clean, the countertops are clean, and everything just kind of looks brand new. We still have the piano, which we have to keep. Remember I mentioned in the last video, but they have all the workers, the construction workers, they have all their stuff here still because there's still some work they have to do. You have to paint up over here. This is a living room area. Remember there's a half bathroom there. And then we come up to the third floor. One thing we were thinking about, or we thought about, is that this is a very, very huge upgrade. Obviously a huge upgrade from where we've lived before. And there's a lot of room here. So the one thing I'm kind of like, I guess, freaking out about is the furniture amount. But I mean, when you think about it, our combined furniture, I guess together, I think it'll be enough to fill up this entire home. So this is the master bedroom. Which is on the third floor. Guest bedroom, guest bathroom. Have the sliding doors right here. Shower is finished. That needs to be filled up. Bathtub, double sink. And then of course, I'm not gonna go upstairs again. You guys already know what's up there. I'm really excited. Ever since we like found this home, we've been like counting down the days. And for some reason, whenever you like get excited about something, you always think that it's gonna take forever to happen. And this day kind of just like snuck up on us. So now we're gonna go celebrate our home and
with some wine
and her getting off some antibiotics and stuff like that. So we're gonna go celebrate with some wine and relax. Everyone should have their self-care nights where they just treat themselves with
some takeout.
Love, so maybe some takeout, a Netflix movie, and then some sex. I'm just kidding. Good morning, guys, and welcome to the second day of this vlog. I am in my passenger seat. This is a very rare sighting, and the bae is driving. So today is our 1 year anniversary, and she's taking me somewhere apparently I've never been, and she has a whole day planned out for me, and there's 4 steps. So I was getting calendar invites this entire week, and if you look at my phone, there's step 1, which we're doing right now, step 2, step 3, and then there's step 4. So there's 4 steps today, and you guys are gonna get the grand pleasure of being walked through all of these steps. It's gonna be just as new to me as it is to y'all. You guys picked a good vlog.
First stop, Whataburger.
No.
Yeah.
Bro?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. We're at this place called Tiny Boxwoods, and I'm still trying to figure out what it is. It seems as if it's a outside garden / restaurant, so take a look. We have my food right here, which is Amiga Scramble, and we have like a garden area in the background, and some garden areas over there. And behind me, there's a restaurant, which is where we got all the food is, and all the food's coming out of there. But if you're in Houston, if you want to go to a dope spot, a dope outdoor spot where the vibe is kind of chill, this is definitely a good spot. Can't really confirm on the food yet because I haven't had a bite yet, but I'll let you guys know after this. But it's a pretty cool little spot. It was pretty dope. So that restaurant was absolutely phenomenal. Like, no bullshit. I'd give it like a 9.5 out of 10. The stinginess in me won't give it the extra 0.5, but it was definitely a 9.5 out of 10. And they're well known for their tiny their milk chocolate cookies. So this is a milk chocolate chip cookie, and wow, it's so soft.
And their blueberry scones. You ready for your next surprise?
Yeah. Go.
Yeah.
You don't know, babe, when you hold me and kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change. If I had it my way, you would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning.
What do you think?
It's amazing. I almost shed a tear. Alright, so stop number two of this extravagant day. So we came to a nail salon, which is where she gets all of her pedicures and manicures and all that stuff. They have the normal seating for like the, I wouldn't say normal people, but for like normal seating. And then they have a VIP room. She booked the VIP room for the both of us. And now we're about to get a pedicure and manicure in this room. I'm gonna sip on some wine too. Yep. So excited for the fourth stop. So for the fourth stop, they took me to get my oil changed. I'm just kidding. I'm getting my oil changed right now because I can't continue the rest of the date without an oil change. I've been needing to get my oil changed for about 2 weeks, so I figured I'd get it taken care of today. And then we're gonna go home, take a nap, and then continue the rest of the date. Honestly, today's been amazing. Very amazing. Pretty tired, but the adrenaline rush is keeping me going. There you are. Welcome to day three of this vlog. I think it's day three. And I'm currently in my closet. I know I didn't catch y'all up, or I didn't fill y'all in on like the final steps of our anniversary date yesterday. But to kind of just fill y'all in on everything that happened, I broke my cell phone in that shower right there. So I was showering, and me being the person that I am, I love music. I love jamming music, and I jam music in the shower. Did not have my JBL Pulse with me, and I brought my old phone. This is my new phone. I brought my old phone into the shower. I was playing music. It was funny because Casey warned me before she left, and she was like, hey, like, you shouldn't be showering with your phone in the shower. You're gonna break your phone. You're gonna get water damage. You're not gonna be able to replace it, blah, 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 blah. And of course, I didn't listen to her. And as soon as she left and went home to get ready, dropped my phone in the shower, completely blacked out. And it was pretty much done. It was finished after that. Not only did I get water damage, I completely shattered the front and the back of my phone. And yeah, that was, my phone took its final breaths last night. And I had to rush to the AT&T store, get a brand new iPhone XR, which is pretty much the iPhone X, except slightly bigger. And I got the red one. So I actually feel like this was kind of an upgrade, even though it's supposed to be the cheaper version. I kind of like this one better. The reason I'm in my closet right now is because I've been getting a lot of questions regarding my shoe collection. And I figured, what better day to do this than on a Sunday after completing all my client check-ins, and I have nothing else to do. So we're gonna walk through the shoes, and what we're gonna do is I'm gonna tell you the shoe. So let's get started. First, we have the Flyknit. I think these are the Flyknit Razors. These came out a while ago. Do not wear these anymore. They're just kind of sitting in here. We have the Free Ones, 2.0s, I think. Yeah, these are the Nike Free Runs, 2.0s. We have the Air Max 90s. They're like a clear color. I've had these for a while. Don't really wear them anymore. We have another pair of Air Max 90s. So I kind of like organize my shoes and like, I guess the style of shoes they are. So these are like running shoes, training shoes. The Nike Air Maxes again, highlight orange. The basic Nike White Prestos. I've had these for a while. We have the Gatorade Ones. These came out like last year. I was really hyped when I got them, but I'm not really hyped about them anymore. I'm actually thinking about giving these away. We have the my favorite shoes. If you guys watched my last Q&A, they need to be cleaned. A lot of my shoes need to be cleaned. We have the Nike Chicago Ones, my favorite shoes of all time. These are still reselling for a very good price because they're just that great. We have the Royal Blues, the Nike Jordan Ones, Royal Blues. You have these camouflage Vans. This is like my van section. I have some black and white Vans on right now. Camouflage Vans. You have some white Vans. And that's it. Or that's not it for my Vans collection. I have some more Vans coming up. We have the Nike Lunar Force acronyms with the zipper. So these are pretty dope as well. Don't really wear them as much as I would like to, but now that I see them, I'm gonna start wearing them more. We have the Nike Chicago ones. I keep saying Chicago ones. We have some more Nike Jordan ones right here. We have the Gatorade sixes, which I do not wear as well anymore. We have the John Geigers, the misplaced checks. I love these when I got them, and like some of my other shoes, I don't wear them as much as I want to, but I need to start wearing them more. But those are the John Geigers. We have the fuckboy shoes, the Chelsea boots. These are very hot in 2016, and the entire athletes who wear this nonstop. Girls, if you're dating a guy who wears these every single day, and this is like his go-to fit closer. And I say fit closer because I really, being a shoe connoisseur, I think that shoes complete an outfit. And if this is his fit closer, you gotta buy him some sneakers. That's all I gotta say. I don't really wear my Chelsea boots anymore, but whenever I have to, which is pretty much to almost every club in Houston, I'll put them on. We have some more Vans over here with some Prada loafers, purple Prada loafers or navy blue Prada loafers. Benito Apple Bum version Vans. These came out like last year. These are actually really dope for squatting. I use them when I squat a lot, but yeah, these are the Benito Apple Bums, my last of the Vans collection. We have the LeBron, favorite player in the NBA. We have the LeBron 15s. We have the Four Horsemen. Damn, I'm so impressed that I'm remembering this. And we have the LeBron Ghosts. These are the first LeBrons that came out in the 15s, and I copped them on the day they came out. So happy about that. We have the Nike Prestos, Nike Off-White Prestos, the black version. Another one of my favorites. I wear these a lot now. I think I kind of just go through cycles where I just wear shoes that I feel like wearing more than the other ones. We have the Off-White Ones, the UNC Ones. Another one of my favorites. I actually wore these last night. We have the Motorsports, the Jordan 4 Motorsports, one of my favorites as well. And then we have the Travis Scott 4s, Cactus Jacks. I was very hot about these when I got them, but not some more. Damn, I need to clean them. But they're still one of my favorites, and I think they're legendary because I grew up, for those of you that are, a quick fact about me. Travis Scott's from Houston. He grew up in Missouri City. I grew up in Missouri City. Christian grew up in Missouri City. And he lived in a neighborhood, probably like two neighborhoods down from me. So to see him rise to stardom and fame, now he's dating or married to Kylie Jenner with a kid, to see all that happen, it's honestly been completely amazing. But big props to him. We have the Nike Airfare of Gods ones, and these are the black versions. These are dope as fuck. Another one of my favorites that I've been wearing a lot lately. We have the Yeezy 500 utility black. These got fucked up, and I don't know where I wore them and I fucked them up, but I definitely messed them up when I went somewhere. I think I was in a desert somewhere. We have the Vapor Max, the Vapor Air Maxes, I think. Yeah, the Air Vapor Max Pluses. These are another one of my favorites. I love these. Don't wear them as much as I need to or I want to, but they're here. We have the Yeezy Triple Whites. These need to be thrown in the washing machine. We have the Yeezy 750s, the Gumball edition. We have the Yeezy Belugas 350s under the Yeezy 750s. We have the 700s, the Wave Runners, another one of my favorites. We have the Airfare of Gods Lightbone edition. I kind of need to move this. Hold on. I feel like these should be next to each other. It's much better. Kind of fucked these up from the last video I showed you guys to now. I've definitely worn these a lot, and I need to figure out a way how to clean all these. We have some Ultra Boost, the sock edition. We have some more Flyknit racers. We have some Sesame Yeezys that I don't really wear anymore. We have some Ultra Boost, some 2.0 Ultra Boost, and we have some NMDs under there. So that pretty much wraps up my shoe collection. I feel like I have a lot of shoes. What do you guys think? But there's one more shoe that I just got, being the sneakerhead that I am. There's one more pair of shoes that I just got recently. Shout out to Pumped Up Kicks for the hookup again. We have the Sixes, the Infrareds. These are some shoes I really wanted growing up. And growing up, my mom, I was living with my mom, single mom. She was working pretty much slave hours and we couldn't afford it. So when I saw those were coming out, being in the position that I am in now, I was like, hell yeah, I'm gonna get me some. So I got me some and those are another one of my favorites now. But that completes a little tour of my shoe closet. Hopefully I can stop for a little bit, save some money. Well, not even save some money. I think everyone has their own guilty pleasures. Like, I like to spend my extra reward money on shoes. Some people like to spend it on traveling. Some people like to spend it on cars, makeup, jewelry, all that stuff, clothes. But I really take pride in my shoes and I love shoes. I love shoes so much. So if there's a shoe company like Nike, Adidas, watching this right now, if y'all want to throw a boy a shoe sponsorship or contract, I mean. So it's a top down type of day, 68 degrees in the city of Houston. No humidity, just straight up dry heat, which is a good thing, with a slight breeze. So I'm loving today already. Pulled up to the best smoothie locations in the entire world. Yes, I said that. So I literally make it a ritual every freaking Sunday, or every freaking weekend, most likely Sundays. I get this Paradise Found from Juiceland right here in White Oak, the Heights. This is a Paradise Found, the best smoothie on the menu. I usually add a scoop of hemp protein and some CBD oil, and I sip on it for that Sunday pleasure. And then we also have, I'm not vegan, but this is probably the only vegan thing that I can eat with 100% joy and happiness. This is the Beyond Burrito from Juiceland. 19 grams of protein per burrito. So I have two, and it comes out to 38 grams of protein. What a swell way to start off my day. It has some Southern Rep Creole Spiced Beyond Burger, which I guess it's a vegan burger mix, coleslaw, romaine lettuce, remoulade, house quick pickles, and hot sauce. This shit is so good. Like, so good. Sheesh! Man, those Nisis are fire, bro. Where'd you get them from? What's your name?
Billy. Yes, sir.
Nice to meet you, man. Thank you for the support.
Yes, sir.
I'm not gonna lie, guys. Having a pretty shitty workout. But days like these and workouts like this, kind of have to remind myself that, just like the previous clip you saw of the guy wearing the Naka Power knee sleeves, kind of have to remind myself, I don't want to sound like too cocky, but I have to remind myself that there's people out there that do look to me for motivation, inspiration, and they've seen everything I've accomplished in the last 6 to 7 years, and them seeing a video or seeing something like this, a clip like this, will help get them off their ass into the gym. I'm not feeling 100% today, but I'm making it work. Second move of the day, we have lat pull downs. Not moving extremely heavy weight today. I'm gonna stick to 160, 68 reps, 4 sets. Let's get it. Third movement of the day, we have high rows with this hammer strength machine. So on this movement, again, I'm not feeling extremely strong today. So I've lowered the weight. I'm only doing 2 plates. Normally I do 3 plates per side, but today I'm gonna focus on the stretch. I'm gonna be focusing on the stretch, the full range of motion. So I'm doing an iso lateral move. Starting off with my right hand, chest poked out, pulling all the way down, holding up the bottom for 2 seconds, gradually releasing up top, full stretch, same thing. Gang got the hammer and the wrench. I pull up and I put a million of the lot. On this time, we'll be fun, but I forgot. When you complete the workout,
you feel 100 times better. Trust me. And I know I'm gonna feel better after this workout. I just gotta get through it. So we're doing preacher curls. Two plates, 6 to 8 reps, 4 sets. I'm already 1 set in, so I'm gonna do 3 more sets and probably gonna call it a day. All right, so workout was blah, but just pulled up to Kiehl's. There it is. Pulled up to Kiehl's out here in the Heights, River Oaks area. I'm gonna pick up my facial routine. So as a man, I think it's important. I personally think it's important to take care of your face, take care of your skin, because if you're single, not that I'm single, but this is some advice for some single individuals out there. If you're single, your skin is looking right, unless it's genetic, which, I mean, I know that sometimes, most of the times, it is genetic. If you're just a dirty-ass motherfucker and you're not washing your face, or if you're just using low-quality, low-grade facial wash, facial lotion, then I have a strong, strong recommendation for you. And you know what? I'm just going to show it to you. So one of the main products that I get at Kiehl's, first you got to start off the facial washer. So we have the Kiehl's Ultra Facial Cleanser. I use this every single day, morning and night. And then after I get out of the shower, the toner. The Ultra Face Toner, which is something that I put on my face with like a cotton ball. After that, I have the Midnight Oil after the facial toner, I then put on the Ultra Facial Cream. After the facial cream, I then put on the Midnight Oil, which is over here, which I'm not gonna purchase because I already have one at home. But just to show you guys, this is something I put on every single night before I go to bed. And I wake up in the morning and my skin is all fleek. But here are the 3 main products. If you wanna start off small, these are pretty expensive, I'm not gonna lie. But if you wanna start off small, you can obviously get these smaller sizes, which are over here. They have the smaller sizes of everything. But once again, facial cleanser, toner, cream, and then Midnight Oil. Alright, so moving day is very close and I'm about to start packing things up and getting started with this move. You guys have seen my shoe collection. You guys have seen everything. Hope you guys enjoy this video. Wanted to end this video by congratulating the 2 winners that I announced on my Instagram page today. One of them is going to be winning a size 12, don't mind the box, the size 12 Gatorade ones that I probably won like once or twice. And then I'm gonna be giving the other winner my Gatorade sixes that I've only worn like once or twice as well. So these are shoes that I don't really, I guess, use, and I know someone else would find better use with them. So I'm giving back. I hope there's nothing wrong with this. I don't know how this could be viewed as negative or wrong, but giving back some pretty much brand new fresh pairs of shoes to 2 lucky winners. And I want to thank you guys for participating in all my giveaways. Not only the 2 winners, but everyone that participates in my giveaways. Keep participating. Follow me on Instagram at Charlie Coker. And I think that's it. I gotta start packing. So all this is all old Alphalete, old clothes that I don't wear. So I'm about to put all this in trash bags. This is a whole bunch of old Alphalete and gym stuff that I don't wear. So I'm about to put all of this in trash bags. Maybe I'll do another giveaway. I'm not really sure yet. But I gotta get started on this. Moving day is like literally in 2 days, so I have to get started on all this. Thank you guys for watching this video. Comment, like, share, subscribe. Tell your friends, tell your mom, tell your dad, tell your brother, tell your sisters. I love all you guys. I'll see y'all in the next one.